guys. I got a chance to come out in the woods today on this beautiful fall day in Ohio. And I wanted to show you guys how to make a candle out of an Altoids tin, or how to make a survival candle. I wanted to show you guys how to do that today and just enjoy this autumn weather.
Sunshine on my shoulders makes me happy.
Today we will be making a Altoids survival candle. You will need a couple things to do this. 4 tea light candles, at least 2 of which that have the cotton wicks still in them. You will need an Altoids container, which is empty. You will need something to melt your wax in over the fire, and you will need something to take it off of the fire when it's hot. It can be any type of pliers. What you are going to want to do is the 2 tea light candles that you have the wicks still in is take them like this and snap them in half. You want to keep these pieces of wax, toss them to the side, and keep these wicks. So you want to do that with the other one and put it to the side and put the wax aside. Now this is what's gonna go over the fire. Now that I have the fire going, I'm gonna wait for it to die down until I put the wax on it. Once you have your coals melted down, all you wanna do is put your wax in your container in the fire and wait till it is completely liquid. The last thing you want to do is take your wax with your pliers and slowly dump your wax into your tin. Which will cover your tin. When you do that, the last thing you want to do is just let it dry. Let it cool down. Once your wax has set, you can go ahead and close this up, and you are completely finished with your Altoids survival candle. You can fit it down in your backpack, or you can even slide it down in your pocket. Well, I want to thank you guys for staying tuned and watching how to build a Altoids survival candle. Until next time, thanks for watching.
He was born in the summer of his 27th year, coming home.